Good morning, Vananda. Today I am starting power reactors. Okay, in the previous class we are discussing about the what is the diagram for that reactor and what are the components are there in the reactor. Okay, that all will be discussed in the previous class. Okay, now in the present class we are discussing about the commonly used power reactors. How many reactors are to be used commonly in the case of a nuclear power plants? Okay, first of all, the reactor is the heart of a nuclear power plant. Why? Because it is the heart of a nuclear power plant. By using that reactor, the total fission process will be done in the reactor only. What is meant by the fission process? That means the nucleus will be bombardment with that neutron, and then we produce the heavy neutron into small nucleus, and then we release the some amount of heat energy and also the three neutrons. This is the one complete cycle. Each and every cycle we are having the enormous amount of heat energy, therefore that reactions are called as the chain reactions. The total reactions will be done in the case of a reactor only. Okay, that's why it is the heart of a power plant. Okay, therefore the reactor is the heart of a nuclear power plant. Okay, in that commonly used nuclear power reactors are the first one is the boiling water reactor, pressurized water reactor. Next one is the fast breeder water reactor. Okay, these three types of reactors are the very important type of reactors. In the exam point of view also, the three types of reactors are the very important. Okay, in that reactors, we will study about the what is the working principle for that reactor and what is the diagram for that reactor, and also the what are the advantages and disadvantages are there for that reactors. Okay, we will study about only what is the working principle, diagram, and what are the advantages and disadvantages for these all the three reactors. Okay, next we are having the another three reactors are there, that is the liquid metal cold reactor, liquid metal cold reactor. Next one is the heavy water cold reactor moderator. Okay, next last one is the gas cold reactors. Okay, last one is the gas cold reactors. Okay, these are all the six types of power reactors that will be commonly used in the nuclear power plant. Okay, these are all the six types of nuclear power reactors that will be commonly used in the nuclear power plant. Okay, next coming to the first one is, that is the boiling water reactor. Okay, in that first type of commonly used reactors are the boiling water reactor. Okay, what is meant by boiling water reactor? It is also called as the BWR. Okay, BWR. Okay, it is called as the boiling water reactor, and it is also called as the BWR, boiling water reactor. Okay, boiling water reactor, BWR. Okay, this is the basic constructional diagram for that BWR, boiling water reactor. Okay, this is the simplest type of a water reactor. Okay, the boiling water reactor is the simplest type of water reactor. Okay, it has a steel pressure vessel. Okay, this is the steel pressure vessel surrounded by the concrete ceiling. Okay, this is the steel pressure vessel surrounded by the concrete shieldings. Okay, in that the fuel is the enriched uranium is the fuel. Okay, first in that we are having the two important points are there, the which type of fuel is used and which type of moderator is used and which type of coolant is used. Okay, the three points, basic points, are very important in the case of the reactors. Okay, now in the boiling water reactor, in the BWR, the fuel is the enriched uranium. The fuel used is the enriched uranium. Okay, it will be taken as the fuel. Enriched uranium. Is the fuel. Okay, next, what is the next one? Moderator and the coolant. Okay, this is the first one. Which type of fuel is used? Next, second one is the which type of moderator is used. The moderator is used as a ordinary water. O dot water. O dot water means the ordinary water is used as the moderator and also coolant. Ordinary water is used as a both moderator and also coolant. Both moderator and also coolant purpose. Okay, this is the boiling water reactor. Okay, this is the simplest type of reactor. It has a steam pressure vessel. Okay, this is the steam pressure vessel. It is surrounded by the concrete shielding. It is surrounded by a concrete shielding. The fuel is used is the enriched uranium. The fuel used is the enriched uranium. And moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. The moderator and coolant is the ordinary water. Okay, this is the constructional diagram for that BWR. Okay, these are all the control rods and this is the fuel elements. Okay, this is the fuel elements and these are all the control rods and this is the steam pressure vessel. Okay, this is the circulating water and this is the steam outlet. This is the steam outlet and this is the water input from the boilers. Water input to the boilers. Water input to the boilers. Okay, this is the main basic diagram for that boiling water reactor, BWR. Okay, this is the simplest type of the reactor and in this it is surrounded by the concrete shielding or the steel vessel. Okay, in that we are using a number of fuel elements. In between that fuel elements, we are using the control rods. And this is the water input and this is the steam outlet. And this is the water circulating pump. Okay, in the steam is generated in the reactor itself. In that, the steam is generated reactor itself. Okay, in that, the feed water enter into the reactor vessel at the bottom. Okay, this is the feed water enter into the reactor vessel. Okay, this feed water is enter at the bottom of these boilers. Okay, at the bottom of this reactor. Okay, the water is enter into the at the bottom of this vessel. Okay, the feed water enter into the reactor at the bottom and takes heat produced due to the fission of the fuels. Due to the fission of the fuels and gets converted into the steam. Okay, and gets converted into the steam. Okay, this steam lives at the top of the reactor. Okay, then this water, this feed water is entered at the bottom of this vessel and then after completing the operation of this fission process, this water is converted into the steam. Again, that steam is leave at the top of this vessel. The steam is leave at the top of this vessel. The steam is leave at the top of the reactor and after passing through the turbine and condenser returns to the reactors. Okay. Okay, therefore it is the basic constructional diagram for that BWR. Enriched uranium is the fuel and ordinary water is taken as the both moderator and the coolant. Okay, we already well known about the what is meant by the control rods and what is the operation of that moderator and what is the purpose of the cooling. Okay, what is the why we are using the fuel in that boiling water reactor? By using that fuel only the fission process is obtained. Okay, what is the use of that moderator? The moderator is used to convert the heavy atom into light atoms or small atoms. Okay, that will be the heavy atom is bombardment or entered into the moderator. Some energy will be lost at that particular. Then that fast neutron will be converted into the slow neutrons by using the moderator only. Next, what is the purpose of coolant? We require the coolant for that reactor. Then we are using the cooling water as the coolant. Ordinary water will be used as the coolant. Okay, in that boiling water reactor, we are using the moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. The moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. Okay, understand ma? And the fuel is the enriched uranium. The fuel is the enriched uranium. Next, working, it is also simplest form of nuclear reactor. Okay, this is the BWR and then that output steam will be given to the turbines, after that condensers, generators and towers. Okay, this is the simplest form of nuclear reactor. The heat is produced by the nuclear fusion in the reactor core. Okay, and this causes the cooling water to boil, producing the steam. Okay, therefore, the steam is directly used to drive a turbine, after which is cooled in the condenser and converted back to the liquid water. Okay, this water is then returned to the reactor core, completing the loop. In the boiling water reactor, the feed water acts as a coolant. Okay, this is the total BWR construction. This is the complete steel vessel. It consists of a concrete shielding, steel or concrete shielding. Okay, it consists of the number of fuel rods. These are the fuel rods and these are the controlling rods. Okay, these are the controlling rods. In that, the fuel is used as the enriched uranium. The uranium 235 is as the fuel, enriched uranium. Okay, and also the moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. The moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. Okay, after completing the operation of this BWR, that steam will be given to the turbine blades. Okay, then the turbine will be rotated. Again, that steam is going to the condensers. Then after that, by using this cooling water, this stream will be condensated and then it converted into the ordinary water. Then it will be again giving to the boilers again, boiling water reactor again. Okay, therefore we are taking the ordinary water as a coolant and also the moderator. Okay, therefore it is a simplest form of a nuclear reactor. It produced by the nuclear fusion in the reactor core. Okay, this is the total reactor core. This total nuclear fusion will be obtained in that reactor core. Okay, and this causes the cooling water to the boiler producing the steam. Okay, the water is entered in the The water is entered at the bottom of this pressure vessel. Okay, therefore, the water, circulating water or ordinary water, is entered at the bottom of this vessel, and the stream will be out from the top of this vessel. Therefore, it produces the steam energy after completing the fusion process in that reactor. Core. Okay, in that we are using the enriched uranium as the fuel and the ordinary water is the moderator and the coolant. Okay, the purpose of that moderator is that moderator is converted into the fast neutron into slow neutron. What is the moderator purpose? That is, we convert the fast neutron into the slow neutrons. Okay, therefore, this water is, this stream is entered into the turbine blades. After complete operation of these turbines, then that stream is again going to the condensers. Okay, in that condenser, the stream and the water is combinedly condensated. Then it will be converted into the ordinary water. Again, this water is coming to the boiler again. Okay, this is the overall construction for that boiling water reactor. Okay, this is the simplest type of construction. Okay, in that we are using the enriched uranium as the fuel and the moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. At the bottom of this vessel, we are giving the cooling water or the circulating water or ordinary water. Okay, after completing the fission process, the steam will be delivered at the top of this vessel. Okay, therefore, the total fission process will be obtained in the reactor only. Okay, this is the construction of a BWR, that is the boiling water reactor. Some of the important points in this boiling water is the water reactor is the it is a very simplest form of reactors. Okay, it has a steel pressure vessel surrounded by the concrete ceiling. Okay, then the fuel is the enriched uranium oxide and ordinary water is used both for the moderators and the coolants. Okay, this is the working of a boiling water reactor. Next, what are the some advantages and disadvantages are there in the case of a boiling water reactors? Okay, coming to the advantages, it includes a small size pressure vessel. Okay, the heat exchanger circuit is eliminated, in that there is no heat exchanger. Okay, consequently, there is gain in the thermal efficiency. There is no usage of heat exchanger. Okay, there is the use of a low pressure vessel for the reactor as compared to the PWR. Okay, it consists of a low pressure vessel. Okay, the metal temperature remains low for giving the output conditions. The cycle for the BWR is more efficient than the PWR. It operates at a lower nuclear fields. Okay, it includes the small size of pressure vessel and also its construction is very simple. Okay, by eliminating the heating circuit in the boiling water reactor, reducing the cost and gain the thermal efficiency, therefore increasing the overall efficiency. Okay, this is the one of the major advantages in the case of a boiling water reactor. Okay, first one is that the size of the boiling water reactor is less. And second point is the simple in the construction. The construction is simple when compared to the PWR. Okay, there is no heat exchanger in the boiling water reactor. Okay, therefore, no usage of heating exchanger. The space occupation is also less. Okay, therefore, the space occupation is also less, reducing the cost of a boiling water reactor. Okay, these are the some of the advantages in the case of a BWR. Okay, next, coming to the disadvantages. Okay, there is a dangerous radioactive communications are to be delivered. Okay, there is a dangerous radioactive contaminations of that stream. More elaborate safety measures are to be provided. Okay, we are using the more elaborate safety precautions are to be provided. Okay, it cannot meet sudden increases in the load. Okay, it cannot withstand suddenly increases in the load. Next, the last point is the because of danger of small amount of fissile materials passing through along with the coolant, more biological shielding is necessary. Okay, the boiling limit power density on its 3-5% of mass can be converted into the steam. Okay, these are the some of the disadvantages in the case of a BWR. Okay, first one, what is the main disadvantages? Some radioactivities contaminates in the turbines and also the steam that will be very dangerous to the peoples are the living organs. Okay, it cannot meet the sudden increases in the load. It cannot meet the sudden increases in the load. Okay, because dangerous of the small amount of fissile materials passing through the, we are requiring the more biological shielding. Okay, the limits of power density is 3-5%. Okay, these are the some of the advantages and disadvantages in the case of the boiling water reactor. Okay, this is the overall constructional diagram for that boiling water reactor. In that, the mainly important points are the it is a simple and it is a steel pressure vessel surrounded by the concrete shielding. In that, we are using the enriched uranium as the fuel. The moderator and the coolant is the ordinary water. Okay, this is the overall diagram for that boiling water reactor. This is the total steel vessel. It will be surrounded by the concrete shielding. It is the fuels and these are the control rods. Okay, at the bottom of this vessel, the water will be entered and the after completing the process of this fission process, then that steam is going out at the top of this vessel. Okay, there is no heat exchanger in the case of a boiling water reactor. Total operation will be done in the case of a boiling water reactor. Okay, this is the important consideration for that boiling water reactors, and these are the some of the advantages and disadvantages for that boiling water reactor. Okay, next, second one is the pressurized water reactor, PWR, pressurized water reactor. Okay, it is the PWR. Okay, in that we are using the fuel is the enriched uranium. The fuel used is the enriched uranium. Uranium as a fuel. Okay, this is the fuel. Okay, in that, water under pressure is used as the both coolant and moderator. Water under pressure is used as the both moderator and also coolant. Okay, in the case of the boiling water reactor, we are using the ordinary water as a coolant and the moderator. But in the case of a PWR, water under pressure is used as a moderator and the coolant. That means we are using the pressurized water. We increase the pressure of that water is used as the moderator and the coolant. Okay, the pressurized water reactor, its simplest form of water reactor. Okay, is a light water cooled and the moderator. Light water cooled and the moderator. The thermal reactor having an unusual core design. The thermal reactor having the unusual core and the reactor. Okay, it is the PWR is the is used as the enriched uranium as the fuel and pressure vessel is the steel. Okay, that pressure vessel is the steel. In that, the coolant and the moderator is the water under pressure. Water under pressure. Okay, the pressure vessel and the heat exchangers are surrounded by the concrete shielding. Okay, this is the pressure vessel and the heat exchanger. Okay, this is the heat exchanger and this is the pressure vessel. Okay, the heat exchanger and the pressure vessel is completely surrounded by the concrete shielding. Okay, this is completely surrounded by the concrete shielding. Okay, the bulk boiling water is prevented as the water is pressurized to about 150 degrees atmosphere. That pressurized means that we are using the 150 degrees pressurized water. Okay, the hot water for the reactor flows through this heat exchanger. That water for that reactor flows through this heat exchangers. This is the heat exchanger or the steam generator. Flows through this heat exchanger where its heat is transferred to the feed water to generate the steam. After complete the operation of this steam generator, the steam is coming out from that steam generator to the turbine. Steam generator to the turbines. Okay, main important points in that PW are the it is a thermal reactor, okay, it is a thermal reactor using enriched uranium or the clad in the zircoli as a fuel. We are using the enriched uranium or the zircoli as the fuel. Okay, the pressure vessel is of steel. Okay, it will be designed with the steel materials. Next, we are using the moderator and coolant is the water under pressure. Okay, therefore, the pressure vessel and the heat exchangers are surrounded by this concrete shielding. The pressure vessel and the heat exchanger is surrounded by the concrete shielding. Okay, this is the reactor vessel and this is the nuclear fuels and these are the control rods. After completing the fission process, and that heat energy will be coming out from this pressurizer to the heat exchanger or the steam generator. Okay, in that, the water is coming into the condensers at the bottom of this steam generator. After combining this pressurized heat energy to that water, then that increases the stream of the stream of that water. Then that stream is going out from this steam generator to the turbine. Okay, ikkada mana em chestamma reactor lo we are using the enriched uranium as a fuel or the zinc oxide as the fuel. Okay, by using this fuel, the nuclear chain reaction will be obtained in that reactor vessel. By using the control rods, moderators, and the coolant purposes, the fission process will be obtained. After completing the fission process, some amount of heat energy will be delivered. Okay, that will be flowing away from this pressurizer to the steam generator. Pressurizer to the steam generator. Okay, after flowing of this steam or pressurized energy, when the water is giving to that the steam generator by the condenser at the bottom of this steam generator. Okay, eppudaithe maniki condenser nunchi water anedi ee steam generator bottom lo enter avutundo ikkada enter aina water ikkada edaithe pressurized energy heat energy develop ayindo aa heat energy plus water rendu combined ayi మనకి ఇంకా ప్రెషర్ అనేది ఇంక్రీజ్ చేసి దాని నుంచి స్టీమ్ ఎనర్జీ జనరేట్ అయ్యి దట్ విల్ బి గివెన్ టు ద టర్బైన్ ఓకే దట్ విల్ బి గివెన్ టు ద టర్బైన్ ఓకే ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీటింగ్ ద ఆపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ టర్బైన్ అగైన్ దట్ స్టీమ్ ఎనర్జీ ఈస్ గివెన్ టు దట్ కండెన్సర్స్ ఓకే ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ ద స్టీమ్ ఎనర్జీ ఈస్ గివెన్ టు ద కండెన్సర్స్ ఓకే ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీటింగ్ ద ఆపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ కండెన్సర్ అగైన్ ద రీసైక్లింగ్ ప్రాసెస్ విల్ బి అప్టైన్ దెన్ ద స్టీమ్ is converted into the ordinary water then again it will be given to the steam generator itself okay then it will be given to the steam generator itself okay the important points in the case of a pressurized water reactor is the first one is the what is the fuels that is enriched uranium or the zircaloy okay it is a complete steel vessel the coolant and the moderator is the water under pressure okay therefore the pressure vessel and the heat exchangers are surrounded by the concrete shielding the heat exchanger and the pressurized water are surrounded by the shieldings okay this is the one of the important points for in the case of a PWR okay in the typical design concept of a commercial PWR the core inside the reactor vessel is created heat okay therefore the pressurized water in the primary coolant loop carries the heat to the steam generator okay therefore inside the steam generator heat from the primary coolant loop vaporizes the water in the secondary loop okay this is the working this is the working and this is the overall PWR circuit diagram the pressurized vessel and the steam generator or the heat exchanger are surrounded by this concrete shielding both are surrounded by the concrete shielding okay after completing the fission process in that reactor vessel that will be transferred to the pressurizer to the steam generator okay in that the cool water and this heat energy is combined to each other then the steam will be obtained in this case okay that steam energy is given to the turbine blades okay this is the basic working of this pressurized water reactor what is the difference between PWR and PWR is that in the PWR pressurized water reactor we are using the another heat exchanger by using that heat exchanger we increase the pressure of that steam okay next what are the main advantages are there in the case of a PWR that means the pressurized water reactor okay it is a compactness the isolation of radioactive materials from the main stream only okay therefore cheap light water can be used as a coolant and the water okay we are using the light water as the coolant and water it having the high power density okay no shielding is required around the secondary side of that component so okay in that we does not any requirement of that shieldings okay the maintenance of the secondary side of component is easier what is the secondary side of that component that is heat exchanger the maintenance for that secondary side of the heat exchanger is very simple because they do not have to be any decontamination period to work okay they in that there is no harmful fuels are not there only we are having the heat energy and the water in the secondary side okay therefore the overall man rem does receives the during an outages is the low okay it having the high power density okay the advantages for that PWR as the high power density okay next what are the main disadvantages are there in the pressurized water reactor okay the formation of a temperature of the steam okay the coolant water must be highly pressurized to remain the liquid at the high temperatures. Okay, in that we are using the high pressurized water. Okay, then we increase the cost of that pressurized water. This requires the high strength pipings and heavy pressure vessels. Okay, this is the one of the major important disadvantage in the case of a PWR. Additional high pressure components, that as reactor coolant pumps, pressurizers, steam generators. Okay, these are all the additional equipments when compared to the BWR. By adding these additional equipments to that PWR, the space occupation is also increases. The space occupation is also increases. We are having the high losses from the heat exchanger. Okay, we are having the high losses from the heat exchangers and also high power consumptions and we are using the high pressure steam, so a strong pressure vessel is required. Okay, we are using a high pressure steam, so we are using a strong pressure vessel is required. Okay, these are the some of the disadvantages are there in the case of a PWR. PWR means the pressurized water reactors. Okay, what are the important considerations in the case of a PWR, and what is the difference between the BWR and PWR is that it consists of a extra heat exchanger. What is the use of heat exchanger? We increase the pressure of that water. Then quickly we transfer the steam energy to the turbine blades. Okay, in that we are using the fuel as the enriched uranium oxide as a fuel. Okay, we are using the enriched uranium as the fuel. Okay, the pressure vessel is the steel. Okay, okay, in that we, the moderator and coolant are used as a water under pressure. Okay, this is the total PWR. Okay, this is the reactor vessel and this is the steam generator. Okay, ఇక్కడ ఏం చేస్తున్నామో మనం ఈ రియాక్టర్ వెజల్ లో న్యూక్లియర్ ఫిజన్ ప్రాసెస్ అనేది జరుగుతుంది. న్యూక్లియర్ ఫిజన్ ప్రాసెస్ జరిగిన తర్వాత హీట్ ఎనర్జీ అనేది డెలివర్ అయింది. ఓకే, దాన్ని ప్రెజరైజర్ ద్వారా మనం స్టీమ్ జనరేటర్ కి ఇస్తున్నాం. అలాగే ఈ స్టీమ్ జనరేటర్ కి కండెన్సర్ నుంచి వాటర్ ని కూడా ఇస్తున్నాము. ఎప్పుడైతే ఈ హీట్ ఎనర్జీ కండెన్సర్ నుంచి వచ్చిన వాటర్ రెండు ఈ స్టీమ్ జనరేటర్ లో కంబైన్డ్ అయ్యి దెన్ ద స్టీమ్ విల్ బి గివెన్ టు దిస్ టర్బైన్స్, అప్పుడే మనకి టర్బైన్స్ లోకి స్టీమ్ ఎనర్జీ అనేది వెళ్తది. ఓకే, ద రియాక్టర్ వెజల్ అండ్ ద స్టీమ్ జనరేటర్స్ ఆర్ టోటల్లీ ఎన్క్లోజ్డ్ విత్ ద concrete shielding. Okay, this is totally enclosed with the concrete shielding. Total ga mana concrete tho shield chesam. Okay, indulo mana use chese fuel enti, enriched uranium or the zinc alloy as a clad ane fuel ni use chestunnamu. Moderator and coolant vache sariki water under pressure ane danni mana use chestunnam. Okay, water under pressure is used as a moderator and the coolant. Okay, what is the purpose of this moderator? By using that moderator, the fast neutron will be converted into the slow neutron. Slow neutron convert aina tarvata ad reactions lo ki maniki obtained ayi dan nunchi maniki chain reactions jarapi appudu heat energy anedi maniki delivered avutadi. Okay, what is the use of control rods? That control rods are used to controls the fission process. Okay, a reactor lo aina control rods em chestayi maniki fission process ni control chestundi. Ela control chestundi? Evaithe neutrons maniki dissipate avutunayo, evaithe న్యూట్రాన్స్ మనకి ఎస్కేప్ అవుతాయో ఆ న్యూట్రాన్స్ ఏం చేస్తది, అవి అబ్జర్బ్ చేసుకుంటది. ఒకవేళ సపోజ్ చైన్ రియాక్షన్స్ జరిగినప్పుడు ఆ రియాక్షన్స్ లో ఉన్న న్యూట్రాన్స్ అనేవి తక్కువ క్వాంటిటీ ఉంటే ఇవేం చేస్తాయి, ఇస్తాయి. ఒకవేళ రియాక్షన్ లో మనకి ఎక్కువ న్యూట్రాన్స్ పార్టిసిపేట్ చేస్తుంటే అప్పుడు ఈ కంట్రోల్ రాడ్స్ ఏం చేస్తా అబ్జర్బ్ చేసుకుంటాయి. ఓకే, దట్స్ వై ద ఇట్ విల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ యూజ్డ్ టు కంట్రోల్స్ ద fission process only. Okay, the main purpose of that control rods is used to control the fission process. Okay, that is the main applications of that control rod.